Let's talk about rosacea, the redness in the face. Is that, is that hereditary? How does that work?
There is a hereditary component in it.
Okay.
And very often we'll find that individuals who in their youth blushed very easily are people that are more prone to getting rosacea. And there are great treatments for it now.
Okay.
I don't think a lot of people realize that there are a lot of very good treatments
for rosacea. So what are we looking at here? This would be, would you call this an extreme case of rosacea, or is this kind of average? How would you describe this, Dr. Crowell?
Well, it's not the worst case of rosacea I've ever seen,
mm-hmm.
because that is a more pustular form where you get lots of pimple-like, but it's not acne. This is a very different situation from acne. Acne is a bacterial infection, and of course there are other, there are genetic processes that are part of that. But rosacea has no bacteria that we are aware of. It's more of an inflammatory process, and anything we can do to stop that inflammation and stop it early helps prevent progression. And people say, what kind of progression? Well, W.C. Fields, for those who are old enough to remember him, but Clinton is another example, where they start getting this bulbous nose.
Mm-hmm.
That's because of the chronic swelling, redness. It actually causes changes in the skin. And so you want to try to prevent that. Women are a little luckier. They don't get it as badly in terms of the what we call rhinophyma, that change that occurs in the nose. But they can get it too. And so treatment is there and should be sought after if you're one of those individuals.